Hello, is there somebody here?
Is something a noise or a sign or an answer? No.
There is a noise.
Okay, follow the noise.
Just a quick question. No one's gonna come up behind me and scare me, right?
Can you see this?
It's not supposed to be just a scary place. It's not designed to shock people. It's designed to look at people in different perspectives and through different perspectives. And that, I think, is one of the major things behind it, that you basically three times have the possibility to look at the same thing, and you will realize that it does something different with you. The first time it's very personal, as you might be that far away from another person.
I think you have to follow the instruction.
Close your eyes.
The next time you control somebody in the situation, and after a while you so get so much into this perspective that it really kind of feels like your own. And then in the third, when watching it on the big canvas, it's a bit like, well, it's not really for amusement, but it has another distance to it. And that, I think, is a chance to look at things in different ways, and to look at also this intimacy or relationships in different ways and through different eyes. That's something I find interesting.
Make yourself comfortable.
I'm Alexander Schubert, and right now we are in Oslo in an empty bank where we realize a performative installation. So what happens is, when the people enter the building in the basement, they will be handed out those kinds of VR glasses, and eventually they look through these glasses and still see what you would normally see, but everything a bit darker and with a limited vision. Attached to those glasses is a video camera that we see here and a microphone, so that everything that those people who go through the installation C will be transmitted to a monitor and to another headset in four different control rooms. In those four control rooms, we have four people, and each of them sees and hears what one person in the building is doing and gives them commands and instructions what to do. So in the first phase, when you enter the installation, you are given commands and are being controlled by somebody sitting in a control room.
Go.
Hello?
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 Do you hear me?
Hi.
Yep.
How are you?
It's dark.
Where do you want to go first?
Okay, I'm going to guide you.
I don't know.
Shall we try going downstairs?
Let's just go straight.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay, let's do that.
To the right door.
Straight. Further. And the door on the right. Yeah. Straight. This one.
Okay.
So the visitors who come into the building are faced with something like a dark maze, so to say. It's a fairly complex building with a lot of hallways, and coming from those hallways are several rooms, and in those rooms there are performers, and all those rooms offer certain possibilities to interact.
No, they're moving.
Yeah, it looks like they're like epileptic or something.
Yeah.
I want to help them.
Yeah, maybe you shoot them.
But I don't know how.
Seems like they need comforting.
Yeah.
Touch the shoulder. Tell them it's okay.
There are several
okay.
Themes that hold the rooms together, and that is kind of also the background or the motivation of the work. They, as the title of the work, Control, already gives it away, have to do with control, hierarchy, dominance, but also with virtuality, distance, intimacy, and it's pretty much kind of a system with certain rules, which are hard to understand.
It's strange, it's unpleasant, it's... but... Okay.
Is he trying to tell you something?
Maybe he wants me to help him put this back up? No?
You are immediately put into a situation where you kind of, you're giving rules, then at a certain point you have to give rules yourself or commands, but then even when you're in the control room, sometimes you get instruction from one level higher, so it's always very unpredictable of what happens. And it is also very different how people interact in those rooms, so the settings are... Well, they all have kind of a dramaturgy, I would say, but still,
leave the room.
It's very different how people experience it or what people make out of those situations. And that was one of the ideas behind it, to make it necessary to choose what to do with this situation.
What did they say?
He asked for my name and then he asked me to cover my eyes, so I did that.
I would do that there, but okay. Where is he now?
I don't know. He's behind me, I think. Why? He's touching my face.
Is it? It's allowed to go wild if it's unpleasant.
What, sorry?
You can go out if you want, if it's unpleasant.
Maybe I should just leave him. Isn't that rude?
Yeah, it's a bit rude to touch other people's face as well, so...
Good point.
What holds the things together is also a bit of a musical or light aspect to it.
Oh!
All the sounds and the lights kind of underlie the feeling of a bigger structure that is synchronized throughout the whole building. So you have the feeling that the rooms and the whole system kind of works together continuously, and you're part of that.
Get the other ones there, standing up again.
Take it.
Of course, it has this kind of, you know, like hierarchy system, autocratic feel to it, but also it gives the possibility for other kinds of interaction, and to see that and to see what people make out of it and how people react to the fact that they are giving rules is interesting and surprising often. And yeah, that is for me one of the major goals for this piece.
Okay, I promise from now on, okay, I will do what you told me to do.
Okay.
Does it have something for you?
Looks like it.
What is it?
Well, it could be many things. Could be candy, could be drugs. I mean, they're not gonna give me something that'll kill me.
I'm guessing it's not drugs. You're just in a tent in a basement with the stranger eating licorice. It's normal.
Yeah.
I don't know why I'm backing away, but are you there?
Yes.
Ah. Do you see this?
I do.
What the fuck is going on?
Do you think that we are in some sort of experiment?
It feels that way.
Do you think I'm with them?
Yes, you could be.
But if you saw your son in a corridor and it was no light there at all, how did you see him?
I felt him.
You felt him? Are you sure he was there?
Yes.
How? Come.
No, I haven't been here. Oh, it's beautiful.
Yeah. All my friends are here.
Oh, no, no, no more.
There's a dude.
Yeah. Okay. Follow the others. Slowly.
Do
you hear me?
Follow who?
The other people. Slowly.
Oh my god.
Release.
Ah!
I think she really wants me to leave.
The this is the first thing that you experience. And in the second stage, once the first round, so to say, is completed, you kind of move up to the control rooms. So then you sit behind the monitor and you are given the possibility or the task to control one of the new audience members who come in for the first time. So first you are being controlled, then you are controlling yourself, and then in the third stage you move up from the basement where the whole installation takes part, and you go into the ground floor, which is a fancy building with wooden floors and everything looks super nice, and there we got big screens where we can see everything that is happening downstairs. So there you can have a glass of sparkling wine and observe what people are experiencing downstairs.
Sure.
Try to turn a couple of others.
Do you remember this room?
Do you remember the room?
You overlooked something.
Oh.
Okay, so you have to keep looking.
Yep.
Try to turn that way.
Ideally, you should walk out of this installation and everybody has seen something else and has experienced something, and you should also walk out saying, I'm not quite sure what the rules behind this is, or when what happens and why this is happening. So that would be the goal.
I feel like I don't understand what is happening. But I'm still mirroring her.
That's good.
Okay.
Where are you? Yeah, go in the door on the left side.
On the left side?
Yeah.
You think there is someone here?
Just take a look. Okay, go out.
So some of the things are harsh in a way, but then again, some of them are, I would say, very beautiful too. There's actually several moments where people hug and get very close. It's always a kind of distant, kind of a virtual romance in a way. And
hugging her back.
So some of the things are dark in there for sure, but a lot of the things I see in a very beautiful way too.
It's actually a good hug, not a creepy hug. So we're just hugging now. You can probably see it in the mirror.
You can see yourself in the mirror.
Hmm. Is it there?
No.
Is he trying to tell you something?
She's touching my glasses, VR glasses.
Make yourself comfortable.
involved.
Are you sitting down in the sofa?
Yes.
Are you alone?
I don't know, it's pretty dark, I can't see anything. I feel like there's someone in here.
Yeah, I think I saw one.
I heard a voice. Oh! Okay, there's definitely someone here.
How many people are there?
1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5.
Close your eyes.
The person is kind of pulling down.
Pulling down what?
His pants.
What?
So aside from the this kind of all controlling and dominance, it's also the relation between the people in the room and the performers and the kind of social settings that we create where the people need to interact with, which I find very interesting. It's also on different levels that we have then. It's the performer and the visitor. It's a strange, hollow world, like a bit in a computer game or in a virtual reality, obviously. And then there's on the other person in the control room also experiencing some very intimate moments and this kind of what comes across and what is real then and how we relate to that is makes you think at least or makes you consider the different aspects of intimacy and the relationship in a sort of virtual context.
Yeah, it's a pillow of some sorts.
So it's your decision what you're doing.
Yeah. I think I'm gonna lay it back there.
Pick up some more paper and throw it at her.
Okay, now he's mad.
It's okay. The rest of the paper in the box. Okay. What is he doing now?
He's standing still and watching me, cleaning up.
Just stop. What is he doing?
Okay. Now he'll just lay down on the floor on his stomach.
Okay. Lay down on the floor, you two. Close your eyes. You'll be okay. You have me here.
Mm-hmm.
Just close your eyes. Are your eyes closed?
Yes.
Okay. That some of the visitors should refuse to carry out an order is definitely a possibility and also intended. So, for example, in the middle of each cycle, there comes this command from one level higher saying to lie down on the floor. So even that is some people then say, why should I do this? And also really depending on which setting you are right now, it might not be the most comfortable and nice thing to do. But yes, that is totally intended. And it also happened. It happens less than you would think.
No.
But
no way.
To see how this pans out and how people react to that is part of the experiment side of the piece, yes.
Do you want to go up?
Yes.
Okay, go up.
Where is up?
And then now go to your right.
My right?
Just see if there is anything.
Oh, it's lipstick. Maybe she wants it. Hello.
Have you tried the calculator?
Oh shit. She's punching my fingers. Oh shit, the peach is totally destroyed now.
You could try destroying another one. You want to take a bite out of the peach?
It doesn't seem so good, but I could try it. Do you want me to?
Do you want to?
Not really.
Okay.
But I feel like you're the one deciding here.
You feel that?
Yeah.
Why would you feel that?
Because I have no clue what's going on. It seems like you do. Ugh, that's really greasy. Maybe I'd take a bite.
Is he okay?
I'm gonna get up now.
Great.
Shall we follow the woman?
Yeah, let's follow the woman.
I'm gonna go out the door.
What?
Go inside.
Can I go in?
Yes.
Close your eyes and go down to the floor.
Okay.
What do you see?
I see a man on a mattress.
I should go down. He said,
I can hear you
say, I go down.
Stay in this room.
You should stay in this room.
Engage quietly.
Yeah, there's this, engage quietly.
Very nice person with the hair, I think.
Hast du da gerade was gesehen überhaupt?
Ich habe gesehen, dass wir jetzt warten.
I'm super happy and I'm extremely glad how all the performers handled the situation and the energy they bring into it. And it also wouldn't be possible at all to do this without the team that we're doing with Heinrich Horwitz, who's helping with the dramaturgy and the choreography, and with Karl Hoffmann, who's doing the video, and Donny Cassati, who's doing all the tech assistant stuff. How we entered this building is, and what we had to do in this building was really beyond what is realistic to pull through in this time frame. And yeah, it's this kind of big team of people kind of made it possible, and that's actually far from normal. And everybody kind of did not stick only to their responsibilities. Everybody was building something, laying cables on ladders, and everybody did everything. And through this, it was possible to create this crazy world downstairs.